Turn your swords to their sheaths, dispel your magic spells, unstring your bows. There's far more important business.
Blood Bowl!
Yes! And our welcome goes out to all of you. Once again, your humble servants are here to bring you the match, live from the ground.
There really is a yawning gap between these two teams today.
No contest!
The supporters don't seem too worried. In fact, they're looking forward to the match.
What a nice day! Perfect Blood Bowl weather, Bob.
Yes, Jim, ideal weather for a game of Blood Bowl. Though I'm not sure it will end nicely for all the players. Did you know, Jim, that the Tlax Warriors were the first people to win the Zlatan Cup back in 2491?
You mean no one else had won the cup before, Bob?
No, Jim. It was the first time a non-lizard team participated in the Lustrian Cup, and the Amazons took it by storm and grabbed the trophy from Sotek's word.
Here we go again for another bloodbath.
Doping is really endemic in this sport.
Isn't it written into the game rules? This player is gonna have a little nap.
And the wake-up will not be too early after this one.
That reminds me of when I took Griff to bits in the 91 final against Reitland.
Oh yeah, you kneecapped him.
Down and eat the dust. It's good for you.
Her studs may have seen plenty of service, but they're still in good working order.
As the remains of her opponents testify.
Ha! Oberwald said, and I quote, "Thank goodness that the humans are around to raise the level of the game." What do you think?
Well, that was true a few years back, but today him and his buddies are no longer at the top of the rankings.
Looks like there was some bad blood between those two, hey, Bob?
Yeah, Jim. Something to do with swapped body parts.
We don't see much of the Heroes of Lore these days.
I don't know.
For any spectators who aren't aware, the Heroes of Lore hope to show the world a better way by honest, strategic play on the pitch.
It's probably a good thing we don't see them. I think she's singing him a lullaby.
The Amazons!
Yes, Jim. Scantily dressed women that hit first and ask questions later.
Yes, Bob. I just wish there were more women like that.
Don't we all, Jim? Don't we all? Poetry in motion.
What we'd like to see
more often.
This player was really strong. Do you think they have some troll blood in them?
Could be. Or maybe his opponent shouldn't speak that way about the family.
Is it
true that most of the Amazon team's devoted fans consist of young men, Bob?
Not at all, Jim. I've heard a large portion of their fan base consists of disgruntled homemakers and countless scores of former Bloodweiser babes.
Aha! That would explain why the Amazon fans had their own fans themselves. One regulation clobbering. Did you hear about the Venus Man-Eaters, Bob?
Oh, yes, Jim. I think everyone knows about the Man-Eaters.
Oh, I'm scared, Bob.
So is everyone with proverbial coconuts. These exotic Blood Bowl players are fairly new to the game, Jim.
Yes, Bob. They mesmerize me every time they enter the pitch.
Ah, yeah, Jim. These lustrian Amazons sure have added some flavor to the game.
Look at that. Whoa!
Oh, wow! Ow!
Nice left punch, right on the nose.
Sure was, Jim. It's broken now. In a game as physical as this, the player is really in the right place.
Exactly. It's really ugly.
Ah! These exotic Blood Bowl players are fairly new to the game, Jim.
Yes, Bob. They mesmerize me every time they enter the pitch.
Ah, yeah, Jim. These Lustrian Amazons sure have added some flavor to the game.
Look at that. Whoa!
Oh, wow! Ow!
And don't forget, children, don't try and do this at home. Remember, these are seasoned professionals.
Well, one of them is anyway. There was a time when the Colleges of Magic hadn't yet ruled on limiting wizard assistance to teams.
Who could forget the infamous 2472 Quagmire incident, when rampant spellcasting caused the entire Bright Crusader Stadium to sink into the earth?
Nobody could forget that. People were blinded for miles around the stadium.
That face job is a lot cheaper than a plastic surgeon.
I don't know if he planned it, but it won't do him any harm in the looks department. Right in the face. The other guy couldn't dodge that one.
Blood Bowl is reputedly the toughest of all sports.
So they say. But it really only comes down to taking a few hits.
You can't say much about that.
Full-blooded, but perfectly legal. A perfect Utsurigoshi.
What's that when it's at home?
In layman's term, a stab on the skull.
Huh.
mighty Zug was swayed by pleas for power. Broadcast into the stands during his last match. He pulverized all the supporters.
Trust him. He likes a job well done. Hold still and then pow! Right in the face!
Right in the face. The other guy couldn't dodge that one.
It seems this player does all the talking with the fists.
And they clearly know how to get heard. And today's question, which will allow one lucky viewer to win a year's subscription to Spike Magazine, is... which player won the 85, 87, 91, and 99 Blood Bowls with the Reichland Reavers? Was it Griff Oberwald, his wife, or his future son?
Easy peasy.
Especially as two of them never touched a ball.
Finesse, what style, what perfection.
What a hammer blow. And the dispatches just come in. Scandal during the World Doping Conference held by the humans. The three dwarf participants were warned too late that it wasn't a mug of beer and had been placed on their necks. Thank you.
we can congratulate the Junior Paravon Stink Team, who have won the Junior Dungeon Bowl for the second year running.
Well done, Spawnlings. And it's interesting to know that the names of several of these youngsters are already on the lips of many of the major team coaches.
The ball changes hands.
That'll do nicely.
Griff Oberwald said, and I quote, "Thank goodness that the humans are around to raise the level of the game." What do you think?
Well, that was true a few years back, but today him and his buddies are no longer at the top of the rankings.
We can congratulate the Junior Paravon Stink Team, who have won the Junior Dungeon Bowl for the second year running.
Well done, Spawnlings. And it's interesting to know that the names of several of these youngsters are already on the lips of many of the major team coaches.
Yep, upside down. That's one way to look at things. I doubt he'll be taking any further part in the match after that.
No, we've still got two legs.
Thank you.
Just look at the fans. They're red hot. A majority of supporters reckon that the league should take measures to prevent the small minority of peaceful fans from watching a match from the terraces.
They've got a point. If they don't want to join in the fun, they might as well stay home and watch it on cablevision.
Very nice elbow drop. Perfectly executed.
And today's question, which will allow one lucky viewer to win a year's subscription to Spike Magazine, is which player won the 85, 87, 91, and 99 Blood Bowls with the Reichland Reavers? Was it Griff Oberwald, his wife, or his future son?
Easy peasy.
Especially as two of them never touched a ball. I've heard of teams that have simply disappeared after being abandoned by their supporters.
Let's say that some teams who haven't won a match for several years have been tied up by their fans and thrown into rubbish containers.
It's the only way to end a downward spiral.
One that won't be coming back in a hurry. Finally, there's one that lets his biceps do the talking.
Yeah, but from his opponent's point of view, it was a short conversation.
Thank you.
Every now and again, Blood Bowl throws up a real mixed bag of a team.
Like the Motley Horde. It's made up of a bunch of misfits.
Yeah, can't be easy to coach those cast-offs every day of the week.
Did you hear about the Venus Man-Eaters, Bob?
Oh, yes, Jim. I think everyone knows about the Man-Eaters.
Oh, I'm scared, Bob.
So is everyone with proverbial coconuts.
The players are ready. Did you hear about the Evil Gits? The team that is made up of the mix of evil players?
Their fans won the Most Evil Supporters of the Year award. Fully merited from what I've seen.
corruption so widespread that the Referees Guild has set up rules concerning where, when, and how one can accept a bribe.
Under an agreement signed last season, clubs are not allowed to offer less than the going rate. I don't know if he really liked that uppercut.
He may not have liked it, but he certainly ate it.
On the schmuzzle.
He'll have a bit of trouble blowing his nose from now on.
Oh, the Amazons!
Yes, Jim. Scantily dressed women that hit first and ask questions later.
Yes, Bob. I just wish there were more women like that.
Don't we all, Jim? Don't we all? Ha-ha! Stunned!
What an idiot! Look over there. Some cute little elf beauties are selling Big Moot sandwiches in the stands.
Hey, I'm off to get one. I'll be back in 5 minutes.
And so now you like Big Moot sandwiches?
No way! A little elf beauty, yeah.
This pair was really strong. Do you think they have some troll blood in them?
Could be. Or maybe his opponent shouldn't speak that way about the family.
and the dispatchers just come in. Scandal during the World Open Conference held by the humans. The three dwarf participants were warned too late that it wasn't a mug of beer that had been placed on their desk. That's what happens when a pro crosses an amateur.
Yes, splotch. The Referees Guild has decided to hire a bodyguard for each game.
Another brilliant idea. And just how effective will one bodyguard be against a stadium full of supporters?
True. Could be a bit one-sided.
The Blood Bowl annals are littered with the stories of teams who've gone bust with crippling debts.
And with the cost of doping and bribery on the rise, the problem won't be going away.
Oh, brilliant sidekick to the face. Let's see that again in slow motion.
Brilliant pass!
As you say, good job! Huh.
mighty Zug was swayed by Green's football, broadcast into the stands during his last match. He pulverized all the supporters.
Trust him. He likes a job well done.
Sleep.
Little baby gets his medicine and he's having a little nap. Today's insight comes from Jaime Schnivel, coach and owner of the Goblin Lowdown Rats team. In yesterday's Spike magazine, he said that Blood Bowl was like war. No winners, just survivors.
Oh, that's deep. About as deep as his team's position in the rankings.
Very nice elbow drop. Perfectly executed. Wizards have not always been able to cast spells safely from behind the sidelines. Were you playing at the time in an Albion League, a second division that prohibited spell casting from off the pitch?
Oh, yes. They were great times. I remember fans traveling to games just to see how well Wizards stood up to the charge of a raving Blood Bowl star. The noise created by a sizzling fireball, followed by the characteristic sound of the snapping of a wizard's neck. That's the sort of technical error that can cost you the game. A recent medical report stated that cerebral hemorrhages were less frequent in Blood Bowl players. Amazing, when you come to think of it.
Not really, when you consider that brains are also less frequent.
What violence?
Yes, it's a great spectacle, Bob.
The Blood Bowl annals are littered with the stories of teams who've gone bust with crippling debts.
And with the cost of doping and bribery on the rise, the problem won't be going away.
Incoming!
Well, it is a violent sport. Griff Oberwald said, and I quote, "Thank goodness that the humans are around to raise the level of the game." What do you think?
Well, that was true a few years back, but today him and his buddies are no longer at the top of the rankings.
Thank you.
Look over there. Some cute little elf beauties are selling Big Moot sandwiches in the stands.
Hey, I'm off to get one. I'll be back in 5 minutes.
And so now you like Big Moot sandwiches?
No way. A little elf beauty, yeah.
Typical of the referee. The players just get warmed up and he brings them off the field.
I reckon that several players will appreciate a few minutes' rest. And the halftime break is coming to a close. Time for the players to get back on the pitch.
I can see one trying to hide up in the stands.
Don't worry, the fans will throw him back. Did you know, Jim, that the Tlax Warriors were the first people to win the Zlatan Cup back in 2491?
You mean no one else had won the cup before, Bob?
No, Jim. It was the first time a non-lizard team participated in the Lustrian Cup, and the Amazons took it by storm and grabbed the trophy from Sotek's word. And today's question, which will allow one lucky viewer to win a year's subscription to Spike Magazine, is which player won the 85, 87, 91, and 99 Blood Bowls with the Reichland Reavers? Was it Griff Oberwald, his wife, or his future son?
Easy peasy.
Especially as two of them never touched a ball.
Is it true that most of the Amazon team's devoted fans consist of young men, Bob?
Not at all, Jim. I've heard a large portion of their fan base consists of disgruntled homemakers and countless scores of former Bloodweiser babes.
Aha! That would explain why the Amazon fans had their own fans themselves.
Incoming!
Well, it is a violent spot.
A drop of the shoulder, and the player is passed.
Look at him go!
Yeah! Clear the runway for a touchdown!
Oh, the Amazons!
Yes, Jim. Scantily dressed women that hit first and ask questions later.
Yes, Bob. I just wish there were more women like that.
Don't we all, Jim? Don't we all?
There's one that won't be coming back in a hurry. Did you hear about the Evil Gits, the team that is made up of the mix of evil players?
Their fans won the Most Evil Supporters of the Year award. Fully merited from what I've seen.
It's so nice to hear the cracking of bones.
Ah, yeah. yeah, reminds me of the good old days.
When a man was a man and a fracture was a fracture.
And the dispatch has just come in. Scandal during the World Open Conference held by the humans. The three dwarf participants were warned too late that it wasn't a mug of beer that had been placed on their desk. You think you'll be able to get up after that blow, Jim?
Oh, yes. He's not the sort to stay down. If he hit him any harder, he'd have punched him straight into the infirmary.
Don't worry. That's where he'll be waking up.
They can start to move forward. The Referees Guild has decided to hire a bodyguard for each game.
Another brilliant idea. And just how effective will one bodyguard be against a stadium full of supporters?
True. Could be a bit one-sided. Right hook was worthy of a black orc.
You're telling me it'll take a while to get over it.
That's one regulation clobbering.
Did you know, Jim, that the Trax Warriors were the first people to win the Zlatan Cup back in 2491?
You mean no one else had won the cup before, Bob?
No, Jim. It was the first time a non-lizard team participated in the Lustrian Cup, and the Amazons took it by storm and grabbed the trophy from Sotek's word.
Come on.
It seems this player does all the talking with the fists.
And they clearly know how to get heard.
Corruption so widespread that the Referees Guild has set up rules concerning where, when, and how one can accept a bribe.
Under an agreement signed last season, the clubs are not allowed to offer less than the going rate. What does R.I.P. stand for, anyway?
Repose in pieces? These exotic Blood Bowl players are fairly new to the game, Jim.
Yes, Bob. They mesmerize me every time they enter the pitch.
Ah, yeah, Jim. These Lustrian Amazons sure have added some flavor to the game.
Look at that. Whoa!
Oh, wow! Ow!
He's knocked him senseless.
You're assuming then that he had something between his ears to begin with. Today's insight comes from Jaime Schnivel, coach and owner of the Goblin Lowdown Rats team. In yesterday's Spike magazine, he said that Blood Bowl was like war. No winners, just survivors.
Oh, that's deep. About as deep as his team's position in the rankings. In a game as physical as this, the player is really in the right place.
Exactly. It's really ugly.
I think she's singing him a lullaby. Thank you.
don't see much of the Heroes of Lore these days.
I don't know.
For any spectators who aren't aware, the Heroes of Lore hope to show the world a better way by honest, strategic play on the pitch.
It's probably a good thing we don't see them. Her studs may have seen plenty of service, but they're still in good working order.
As the remains of her opponents testify. Wizards have not always been able to cast spells safely from behind the sidelines. Were you playing at the time in an Albion League, a second division that prohibited spellcasting from off the pitch?
Oh, yes. They were great times. I remember fans traveling to games just to see how well Wizards stood up to the mad charge of a raving blood Doping is really endemic in this sport.
Isn't it written into the game rules? Hmm. We can congratulate the Junior Paravon Stink Team, who have won the Junior Dungeon Bowl for the second year running.
Well done, Spawnlings. And it's interesting to know that the names of several of these youngsters are already on the lips of many of the major team coaches.
The players are positioned, and we're off. You can't say much about that.
Full-blooded, but perfectly legal.
She's got the ball!
Mighty Zug was swayed by pleas for calm, broadcast into the stands during his last match. He pulverized all the supporters.
Trust him. He likes a job well done.
Nice play with the ball. They've been training well.
A recent medical report stated that cerebral hemorrhages were less frequent in Blood Bowl players. Amazing when you come to think of it.
Not really, when you consider that brains are also less frequent.
Ten dispatches just come in. Scandal during the World Doping Conference held by the humans. The three dwarf participants were warned too late that it wasn't a mug of beer that had been placed on their desk.
Just look at the fans. They're red hot. A majority of supporters reckon that the league should take measures to prevent the small minority of peaceful fans from watching a match from the terraces.
They've got a point. If they don't want to join in the fun, they might as well stay home and watch it on cablevision. Reminds me of when I took Griff to bits in the 91 final against Reitland.
Oh, yeah. You kneecapped him. Blood Bowl is reputedly the toughest of all sports.
So they say. But it really only comes down to taking a few hits.
This player has opened the slapping box and gives rather generously.
Hmm.
Griff Oberwald said, and I quote, "Thank goodness that the humans are around to raise the level of the game." What do you think?
Well, that was true a few years back, but today him and his buddies are no longer at the top of the rankings.
Nice left punch, right on the nose.
Sure was, Jim. It's broken now. End today's question, which will allow one lucky viewer to win a year's subscription to Spike Magazine, is which player won the 85, 87, 91, and 99 Blood Bowls with the Reichland Reavers? Is it Griff Oberwald, his wife, or his future son?
Easy peasy.
Especially as two of them never touched a ball.
He checked that move.
Made him look stupid, you mean? The bench seems to be in two minds about what to do about the player lying prone on the pitch.
Yeah, they don't know whether to send on a stretcher or a coffin.
Mighty Zug was swayed by pleas for call, broadcast into the stands during his last match. Pulverized all the supporters.
Trust him, he likes a job well done. Now there's one that won't be coming back in a hurry.
Final whistle blows with neither team.